Hi everyone! Welcome to my YouTube channel where you can find videos that will make math more fun and easy for you to become winner in numbers, winner in life. Hi! Once again, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is ROWEL CARPIO, a math teacher and a coach, and I do math tutorial in my YouTube channel. If this is your first time to visit my channel, kindly hit the subscribe button found below and hit the notification bell button for you to be notified every time I upload new video. If you find the content of my channel is worth sharing with others, kindly share it with them and please don't forget to leave a comment on the comment section found below. Thank you! This time, let me shout out to the three viewers who commented with the correct answers on the exercises given on the video on how to multiply fractions. They are the following: Emmanuel Enriquez, Shamara Hanna Aborod, and Mishaal Jiban Aborod. Once again, thank you to all of you for supporting my channel. I hope that you will continue supporting my channel by watching all my future videos. Thank you! In this video, I'm going to present to you how to rename mixed numbers into improper fractions and vice versa. Let us have example number one. We are going to rename the given illustrations into a mixed number and improper fraction. Now, first, we are going to name the given illustration as a mixed number. So, when we say mixed number, this number is composed of a whole number and a fractional part. So first, we are going to identify the number of whole in which the figure is shaded with red. If we look at our illustration, we can see that there are two of one whole shaded with red. So this is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. And then, we have also 1/3, since one part out of the three equal parts is shaded with red. So this is 1/3. So 2 plus 1/3 will give us 2 1/3. So meaning to say that the red shaded parts in this illustration is 2 1/3. So this is in mixed number form. Now, how are we going to write this mixed number in improper fraction? When we say improper fraction, an improper fraction is a fraction in which the value of the fraction is equal to or greater than 1. We can immediately identify if the given fraction is an improper fraction if the numerator is bigger than the denominator. So, if we look at here, 1 whole is just equivalent to 3/3. So we have 3/3 plus 3/3 will give us 6/3. Since we learned that when we are adding similar fractions, we only add the numerators and then copy the common denominator. Plus we have 1/3 here, so 6/3 plus 1/3 will give us 7/3. So in other words, the equivalent of 2 1/3 in improper fraction is 7/3. Now, without the illustration, we can also rename the given mixed number into improper fraction or improper fraction to mixed number. So how do we do that? So when we are renaming mixed number into improper fraction, we just simply multiply the denominator of the fractional part of the given mixed number. So in this case, we have 3. We have to multiply it to the whole number, which is 2. So 3 times 2, and then whatever is the product, we have to add that to the numerator of the fractional part. So in this case, we have 1. So plus 1. So 3 times 2 is 6 plus 1 will give us 7. And then we just simply copy the denominator of the fractional part, which is 3. That's why we have 7/3 as the equivalent improper fraction of 2 1/3. Now, how about if we have the improper fraction 7/3, how are we going to rename that into a mixed number? So, when we have 7/3, we know that when we have a fraction, it also shows division. So in other words, we are just simply dividing 7 divided by 3. How many 3 can we get from 7? We can only get 2 of 3 from 7. So 2 times 3 will give us 6. So 7 minus 6 will give us 1. The quotient will be our whole number, and then the remainder, which is 1 here, will serve as our numerator, and our divisor 3 will be our denominator. That's why the equivalent mixed number of 7/3 is 2 1/3. Now, let's have example number 2. In our illustration, we can see that each figure is divided equally into 2 equal parts. So, we are going to write the given illustrations in mixed number. We can see here, we have 3 of 1 whole. So, this is 3. And we have the last figure with 1 part shaded to give us 1 half. So, this is plus 1 half. So, in other words, 3 plus 1 half will give us 3 1/2. Now, so how are we going to write 3 1/2 in improper fraction form? So, 2 halves is just equivalent to 1 whole. So, we have 2 plus 2 plus 2 will give us 6 halves. Plus the 1 half will give us 7 halves. So, in other words, the 3 1/2 written in improper fraction form is 7 halves. How are we going to rename 3 1/2 into 7 halves? Again, we have to multiply the denominator 2 to our whole number 3. So 2 times 3 will give us 6, plus the numerator 1 will give us 7. And then we just simply copy the denominator 2. That's why it is 7 halves. Now, how about if we have an improper fraction of 7 halves? How are we going to solve for its equivalent in mixed number form? So, we have to divide 7 divided by 2. So, we have to divide numerator divided by its denominator. So, we have to count how many 2s can we get from 7. So, we have 3. 3 times 2 is 6. So, 7 minus 6 will give us 1. Again, our quotient 3 will serve as our whole number. The remainder 1 will serve as our numerator, and the divisor 2 will serve as our denominator. That's why the equivalent mixed number of 7 halves is 3 1/2. Now, let us go to our third example. We have here illustrations in which each figure is divided into 4 equal parts. We have to write the parts of a whole shaded with red in mixed number form. So first, we have to identify how many 1 whole do we have. So 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 of 1 whole. And then the last figure, only 1 part is shaded out of 4 equal parts. So we have plus 1 fourth to give us 3 1/4. Now, how do we write 3 1/4 in improper fraction? So 4/4 is just simply 1 whole. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 is 12 over 4. So 12/4 plus this 1/4 here will give us 13/4. So in other words, the 3 1/4 when written in improper fraction form is 13/4. So how do we get 13/4? So we have to multiply the denominator, which is 4, to the whole number 3, and then we have to add the product to the numerator, which is 1. 4 times 3 is 12 plus 1 is 13. So we have 13, and then copy the denominator 4. That's why it's 13/4. Now, how do we also rename 13/4 into a mixed number 3 1/4? So we have to divide numerator 13 divided by the denominator 4. So 13 divided by 4 will give us 3. 3 times 4 is 12. So 13 minus 12 is 1. Again, the quotient will serve as our whole number. The remainder 1 will serve as our numerator, and our divisor 4 will serve as our denominator. That's why the equivalent mixed number form of 13 fourths is 3 and 1 fourth. Now this time, what if we don't have any more the illustrations? So we have here the following mixed numbers. We are going to identify the equivalent improper fraction of each of these mixed numbers. And also, we have to identify also the mixed number of each of these given improper fractions. Now, let's start with 2 and 4 sevenths. In our discussions earlier, when we are renaming mixed number into improper fraction, we have to multiply the denominator to its whole number. So in this case, we have to multiply 7 and 2. And then whatever is the product, we have to add that to the numerator, which is 4. So 7 times 2 is 14. 14 plus 4 is 18. So our numerator here will be 18. And then the denominator, we just simply copy the denominator of the fractional part of the given mixed number, which is 7. So you have 18 over 7. Now, for number 2, 5 and 3 fourths. Again, we have to multiply the denominator 4 to the whole number, which is 5. And then whatever is the product, we have to add that to our numerator, which is 3. So 4 times 5 is 20 plus 3 is 23. And then just simply copy the denominator of the fractional part of the given mixed number, which is 4. So our improper fraction for the given mixed number is 23 fourths. Now, how about from improper fraction to mixed number? We have here number 1, 24 fifths, 24 over 5. So, in our discussions earlier, we have to divide the numerator. So, in this case, 24, divide this by the denominator, which is 5. How many 5 can we get from 24? We can only get 4 of 5 from 24. So 4 times 5 is 20. So 24 minus 20 is 4. So when we write the mixed number form of 24 fifths, that is equivalent to 4 and 4 fifths. So the quotient 4 will be our whole number here. The remainder 4 will be our numerator, and the divisor 5 will be our denominator. And finally, we have 36 sevenths. So we are going to divide 36 divided by 7. So we have to count how many sevenths can we get from 36. We can only get 5 of 7 from 36. So 5 times 7 is 35. 36 minus 35 will give us 1. So when we write 36 sevenths in mixed number form, is equivalent to 5 and 1 over 7. So 5 and 1 7. So you have there how to rename a mixed number into improper fraction and vice versa. So this time, it is now your turn to answer the following exercises. All you have to do is to answer the following questions. And then when you are done answering the questions, you may post your correct answers on the comments box found below. Now, question number 1. What is the equivalent improper fraction of the mixed number 24 and 7 tenths? And number 2, what is the equivalent mixed number of the improper fraction 50 fourths with the fractional part in lowest term? So I hope that you have learned and enjoyed watching this video. See you again on my next video. Thank you.